This could be the final word on the scandal that ended with five Gophers football players expelled or suspended from the U of M after an allegation of sexual assault in a Dinkytown apartment.
Were the students treated fairly?
Yes.
John Marty and Jillian Kornblatt were part of the outside counsel the Board of Regents asked to examine whether the university followed the law and its own policies throughout the ordeal. And they found that yes, the school did.
The process worked in the way in which it was intended.
Although the accused players were cleared of criminal charges, the team suspended 10 of them from football activities following the university's own investigation.
Effective immediately, we will boycott all football activities.
Teammates nearly sat out the Holiday Bowl in protest.
You had the football team that suggested they were going to boycott the event. And I think one of the contributing factors to that, as we found in the report, is that there were some leadership deficiencies.
Those attorneys blamed poor communication and leadership by the football coaching staff. Head coach Tracy Clays lost his job in the fallout. The 10 players who were recommended for discipline by the university pled their case to a hearing panel. That panel and further appeals exonerated five of them.
That's part of due process.
Now it will be up to the Board of Regents to evaluate this final report and decide what to do with the attorneys' suggestions.
I think we've got to be better.
And some of the suggestions given by the lawyers include simplifying the student-athlete code of conduct to standardize violations and possible punishment and more clearly define this whole process to avoid that confusion. Randy?
All right. Thank you, Lou.